the idea that Socius should be banned. Well, in September 2022, I published this study, Sexual Orientation Change Efforts Do Not Increase Suicide. And this was based on a reanalysis of the same data that the Blosnic et al. Study had done. And I found that the conclusions presented by Blosnic et al. Were not only untrue, like they would be a mistake or something, but they are emphatically the opposite of truth. I don't want to say that their study was fraudulent, but it purposely ignored scientific standards of evidence to point to causation with regard to soci harm. This study was immediately attacked. That is, my study led to hostile reviews, heartfelt pushback, we might call it, from the following individuals over the next 6 months. This was Elon Meyer, the founder of the minority stress theory, who now works at the Williams Institute, Douglas Haldeman, whom we saw earlier, who published the case against conversion therapy, and Judith Glasscold. They both wrote critical pushback commentaries on my study. Lauren Beach, you may remember her from as the person who organized the letter of denouncing the Meyer McHugh's New Atlantis article on sexuality and gender. And then Danish bioethicists Strizzi and DiNucci, who argued, believe it or not, that my study was nefarious and egregiously problematic because it restricted the advance of gay rights, and thus it was an unethical thing even to publish it, even if it were true. All of these are honest arguments made in the literature. You can read them for yourself. So what did my study show? Well, I used the same data that Blosnic et al. Had used. It's very good data. It's one of the first sets of data that is population representative for sexual minority persons. And they got about 1,500 of those and used the Gallup organization to draw a good sample.